You have heard the reports. What a wonderful report. What a wonderful way this school has grown, has developed. And Reverend Matt Saunders and her team that founded this school so many years ago, I'm sure they'll be proud of the steps that we have taken to be where we are. Of course, today is a happy day, and we do not want to go into the heavier side of things. But I must tell you that what Ms. Francis did not tell you is that there are challenges. There are challenges. And I'm emphasizing this to see how well we have done despite those challenges. We have a school capacity for 400 students, and our school population is just now somewhere around 150. So you can see that we are underpopulated, and we have to be carrying all the overheads for that number of students. We have to pay the mortgage, which is very heavy for this kind of property. And the point I'm trying to get to is that we do not have the kind of funds to advertise what is happening in the school. You heard the report, and that's the fact, those are the facts. Wonderful stuff is happening here. We don't have the money to advertise. We cannot go on television or the newspapers and say all of this is happening in Meadowbrook because it costs a lot of money. So, what I'm going to ask you all, each and every person here to do, whenever you get the opportunity, please pass the word on to others about what is happening at this school. And that wherever there are opportunities, they will make Meadowbrook Prep School the school of choice. Again, we thank the principal for her report, and we would also like to applaud her and the director for having led the team. Let us give them a big hand. Our guest speaker is not the name that you have on your program. She is actually Mrs. Alicia Lindsay, who is an education officer from the Ministry of Education. And to introduce our guest speaker, we invite Mrs. Shirley Hewitt, our senior teacher, to make the introduction.
Mr. Chairman, other members of the Board of Management, our directors Reed, Principal Ms. Francis, teachers, parents, friends, well-wishers, students. It is indeed an honor to be asked to introduce to you this afternoon our guest speaker. She serves as an education officer in the Ministry of Education, Youth and Information. She has over 13 years of experience in the field of education. Her journey in education started at Boston Primary in Portland, where she served as a classroom teacher for grade 3 students. She later went on to serve at Fair Prospect Primary and St. Richard's Primary. Her journey in the Ministry of Education started with the Education System Transformation Project in 2008. Following the completion of her bachelor's degree in language and literacy, she served as a cluster-based literacy specialist and later as a regional literacy coordinator for Region 1. Today, she holds a master's degree in language and literacy from the University of the West Indies, Mona, and works as an education officer in the Media Services Unit with a primary mandate of evaluating curriculum, support materials, such as textbooks, audio, and video files. Please join me in welcoming Mrs. Alicia Lindsay to the podium.
To the road, my boy. They need a female to tell them what excellence is.
Hardworking, non-stop.
Hardworking, non-stop. That's his definition of commitment. Do you agree?
Yes.
Excellence is achieving your goals.
Excellence is achieving your goals. And those definitions are in line with what I have. To commit is to pledge to a cause or course of action. So commitment is dedication to a cause or principle. And to excel is to be better than or to surpass, to be outstandingly good. Being exceptionally good. Hence, committed to excellence would invariably translate thus: a pledge to being outstanding, to being exceptionally good at one's endeavors, or dedicating oneself to upholding correct principles, values, and attitudes at all costs. It was the Greek philosopher Aristotle who said, and I quote, "Excellence is an act won by training and habituation. We do not act rightly because we have virtue or excellence, but rather have these because we acted rightly. We are what we repeatedly do. Therefore, excellence is not an act, but a habit." Boys and girls, your exit this afternoon from Meadowbrook Preparatory will take you into a new sphere. You will now begin the secondary stage of your education in new environments. And based on the principal's report, most persons have received their first choice. So congratulations to you. You will face new opportunities and possibilities. However, in order to maximize or to make good of these opportunities and possibilities, embrace the theme committed to excellence. Why? And what am I asking you to do? I am asking that you decide right here today that you will achieve the very best of yourselves, your community, and your country. I am asking that you act rightly. I am asking that you excel, that you are to be better than, be more than ordinary, be extraordinary. Not a tagline for one of those telecommunication companies, though. I ask that you commit yourselves to excellence. What will this require of you? It requires, for the most part, four things. First, develop a habit of excellence. Say that with me. Develop a habit of excellence. Secondly, work diligently. Thirdly, think honestly. And last but not certainly least, love yourself and treat everyone as you would want them to treat you. Love yourself and treat everyone as you would want them to treat you. A habit of excellence. Excellence does not just happen. It does not come overnight. One has to be prepared to work, and it means working hard. Then you commit yourself to working hard so that you can excel. On entering grade 7, you cannot wait until the end of the term in December to start working. You have to start working now. So I know most persons after GSAT, they are so happy that it is over, that everything is stored up, and the poor grade 6 teacher, oh, some persons are pointing. The poor grade 6 teacher, she can't get you to do anything. And parents are saying, take up your books, and students are saying, but GSAT is over. But guess what? Guess what? If you are going to do exceptionally well in secondary us winner. All these common courtesies must be among the hallmarks of your lives. Developing a habit of excellence speaks to our deportment, our manners, our behavior. As a child, I learned that proper manners takes you throughout the world without 1 cent in your hands. Well, today, with the cost of living where it is at, that might not equate to more than 1 cent. However, it still remains true that being respectful and displaying a good behavior certainly will make your journey through life easier. Young ladies, you must know that it is not okay to wear clothes and do more to have you naked than clothes. Young men, undergarments mean that such items of clothing are to be worn under the pants and under the shirts. Trousers are made with loops for a reason.
Come on now.
Accommodate a belt to ensure that the trousers are secured at the waist. You must know that putting your clothes on backwards signals that something has gone wrong.
Right.
People with their hats on backwards and pants down are certainly saying that something is wrong.
Come on now, come on now. Keep it going.
Remembering excellence is not an act, but a habit. We must practice the right habits and we will excel. Developing the habit of excellence speaks to our speech. As Jamaicans, we can be very colorful and explosive at times in our speech. We are reminded that a soft answer turns away wrath and grievous words show anger. When we commit to excellence, we must temper our speech, temper the conversations in which we engage. Remember, we are going to be the very best of ourselves for our community and also for our country. The second point was to work diligently. Working diligently means that the work that you do must be done with proper care and effort. Do not be satisfied with just the bare minimum. Do not say, I just want 50% to pass. No, do not settle for mediocrity. Ensure that your work is not done half-heartedly. Excellence must be your goalpost. You will not always get 100%, but when you get 50% or below, do not be satisfied. I must share with you a story. In my days, I didn't do GSAT. I did what you call common entrance, right? And when I left, I grew up in Portland. And when I left the Fairport Square, the primary school, I was placed at Teachfield High. And I was always at the top of my class in primary school. I left at Teachfield in grade 5. At that time, you could do it from grade 5, right? So I left for grade 5. And I expected that I would be at the top of my class when I got to Teachfield. But then, it was a shock. The first test I did was a religious education test, and I got a score of 50%. I could not be consoled. I've never seen that grade before. And so I cried, but guess what? I did not accept that I was always going to get 50%. I determined in my heart that I was going to be the top of the class. And by the end of term exam, I was at the top of the class. And by the end of and throughout high school, I kept being at the top of that class. There are going to be times when the grades are not what you want them to be. But always keep in your mind that I am greater than this low grade. I can achieve.
That's right.
And you will achieve once you work towards the boys and girls. Boys and girls, you must know that there is dignity in work. Your work is your signature. So ensure that you are signing to excellence. Whatever you do, do it with pride. And make sure that it is of the highest standard. Thirdly, think honestly. When our thoughts are honest, our deeds generally tend to be honest. Boys and girls, young ladies and young men, committing yourselves to excellence demands honesty and integrity. Honesty that you say and do. It is okay to tell someone that you will not partner with them to do things that are wrong. It is still okay to speak the truth. Speak the truth and cut. He who hides does the wrong. Yes, from coming to kindergarten, we have been taught that. Let us remember that. Let us keep it at the forefront of our mind. With purpose in your heart and a commitment to itself, then honesty and integrity are qualities which you must embrace. And finally, love yourselves and treat everyone as you would want them to treat you. One of the greatest commandments our Savior Jesus Christ taught was to love our neighbors as we love ourselves. Parents, teachers, boys and girls, everyone here, can we all imagine the world we will be living in if we obey this commandment? A world of peace, a world free of crime, free from fear, a world of love and harmony. Everyone wants to be treated perfectly. So if we each give to the other what we want for ourselves, then it goes without saying. Excellent world, peace, tranquility will be ours. I therefore ask you to endeavor to love yourselves and treat everyone as you would want them to treat you. You are beautiful. When you look at yourself, tell yourself that you are beautiful and love the skin you are in.